Hey guys, it's me again, Simon Abele. Today I make a review about my color grading, color correction process in Premiere Pro. I shoot mostly with my Setcam E2, which shoots in the color profile Setlock 2, which is a really flat curve. And this color profile preserves a lot of the highlights and you can repair them in post. So for the beginning, I start my Premiere Pro. I know a lot of you are using other programs like DaVinci, Final Cut, whatever. And I'm just used to this program through my work and through the past few years. And I think in the last time, they have also improved a lot their color management and their color correction tools like Lumetri. And yeah, that's the reason for I use this program. I simply drag my sequence into the timeline. This shot was taken during daylight and yeah, you have pretty sharp edges and sharp contrast. And I just want to show you what you're capable of doing with Lumetri and with the color plugin from Setcam itself. Make sure first to download the Setcam color plugin for Premiere. This is offered by Setcam itself on their official website. This plugin helps you to recover all highlights, to reduce the gain, to reduce the offset, whatever you need to do. You have all the adjustments and all the sliders available. Which is really important for my workflow is that I'm using the Setcam color plugin. And I'm using Film Convert, which will help me to emulate some of the characteristics of old stock film. Watch out to first apply the Setcam color plugin to your footage and later on use the Film Convert plugin to your footage. In the beginning, it might look a bit strange or desaturated or you get blown out highlights, but don't worry, we will all repair this in post and I will show you how I do this. There you have different adjustments you can do. So the input color space is of course Setlock 2. And for my workflow, it's important also to set the output color profile to Setlock 2 as I am using the Film Convert tool later on. You have two different checkboxes which you can uncheck and check according to your own preferences, and I mostly take the recover saturation checkbox, which will help you to match your saturation again with the shot once you've done some adjustments. And in some cases also the purple edge remove might be necessary, but for this time I just played around with it. Once you apply the Film Convert plugin, just make sure you don't move the slider. So I leave all the settings on default with my Film Convert tool, as this one always makes strange adjustments with contrast and it's just not that pleasing to the eye. So I leave all the adjustments on default and rather stick to my sliders within the color plugin from Setcam. Once you go back to the Setcam color plugin, make sure to have also enabled your Lumetri scope so you have control over your highlights and about the darkest areas, and just try to match this so you do not clip your highlights and you do not clip your shadows. Also quite important, you can make adjustments on your temperature to match like white balance if it was off, which is always kind of a bit fiddling around. I mean, everyone has a different taste in terms of look, if it's too warm, if it's too cold. Just play around with it and get used to the color plugin itself. I don't want to go too crazy with my look, so I'm not crushing the blacks too drastically and to get such a contrasty look. And also with the highlights, I really try not to clip them at all, so you get a pleasing image for the eye and it looks all natural. What is important when shooting with Setlock 2 that you always expose to the right? What does it mean to expose to the right? So when you have your histogram activated on your camera, just make sure to overexpose your image, because otherwise you will get really noisy footage and it's just not that pleasing. So many people make the same mistakes and they underexpose their footage in Setlock 2 and then they complain about noise, and it's just a step you have to understand, and once you got it, always expose to the right and you're good to go with the footage. In the end, I often apply an adjustment layer on top of my footage, and then you can just start your color grading. So once you have corrected all your footage and you got your white balance, your exposure right, then you can start creating your own look. And of course, a lot of people tend to make the teal and orange look, and I also like it because it creates this really interesting contrast between the two colors. And yeah, it's just that you attract more attention to the subject you're filming. And so once I have added an adjustment layer to my timeline, we can open up another Lumetri tab, and within this Lumetri tab we start to find our skin tone. So you can take the eyedropper tool, and then you have to make some manual adjustments to fit your skin tones perfectly and to match it up. So afterwards you can denoise and degrade your masks to make it more pleasing for the eye. Once I've selected my skin tones, I push my midtones all the way to the teal, and I always try not to go too crazy with the look because then it gets overlooked. And yeah, that's the main idea when color grading or color correcting, not to push the sliders too hard. It's like always those subtle small adjustments you do, and they make the difference. And what also is really interesting for the highlights sometimes to bring back some of those yellowish highlights. And yeah, I've seen this especially in the Dunkirk movie from Christopher Nolan. He uses this kind of color grading a lot, and I really just like it. And you can do it as you want with your own preferences, how you like it. That's the part where you can get creative with your color grading. If you have the feeling that your skin tones are slightly off, just take the mask tool and just mask out your skin or a part of the skin, and then within your scopes you can see like the skin line, which most of the skins or all the skins are finding itself within a specific frame. So they are all across this line, and yeah, as you can see here, I was slightly off, and I adjusted my tint or my white balance in order to match this line. And I think the skin tones with Setcam and Setlock 2 are just beautiful and are looking really realistic to the eye. Yes, I hope you really enjoyed my review about my color grading, and here's the final clip. Leave some comments below if you have questions. I can also send you the footage to try around with it and to play around with it. Have fun and see you next time. Bye. Thank you.